You are listening to the voice of the gospel, a proclamation of the Holy Scripture by Wisdom Ministries.
March 5th, Friday. Let's begin this day with the blessings of God. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew chapter 21 verses 33 to 43 and 45 to 46. Listen to another parable. There was a landowner who planted a vineyard, put a fence around it, dug a wine press in it, and built a watchtower. Then he leased it to tenants and went to another country. When the harvest time had come, he sent his slaves to the tenants to collect his produce. But the tenants seized his slaves and beat one, killed another, and stoned another. Again he sent the other slaves, more than the first, and they treated them in the same way. Finally he sent his son to them, saying, "They will respect my son." But when the tenants saw the son, they said to themselves, "This is the heir. Come, let's kill him and get his inheritance." So they seized him, threw him out of the vineyard, and they killed him. Now, when the owner of the vineyard comes, what will he do to those tenants? They said to him, "He will put those wretches to their miserable death and lease the vineyard to other tenants who will give him the produce at the harvest time." Jesus said to them, "Have you never read in the scriptures? The stone that builders rejected has become the cornerstone. This was the Lord's doing, and it is amazing in our eyes. Therefore, I tell you, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to the people that produces the fruits of the kingdom." When the chief priests and the Pharisees heard this parable, they realized that he was speaking about them. They wanted to arrest him, but they feared the crowds because they regarded him as a prophet. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ. Dear friends, today's Gospel is about the parable of vineyard. In Galilee, there were numerous vineyards, and it was quite common for the owners to let their estates to be rented to tenants. Many did it for the sole purpose of collecting rent at the right time. Why did Jesus' story about wicked tenants cause offense to the scribes and the Pharisees? They were offended because it contained both a prophetic message and a warning. The parable of the vineyard speaks to us today also. What is the message of the parable? This parable tells us some important truths about God and the way he deals with the people. First, it tells us of God's generosity and trust. The vineyard is well equipped with everything the tenants need. The owner went away and left the vineyard in the hands of the tenants. God likewise trusts us enough to give us freedom to run life as we choose. God's ways, in one sense, can never become ours. But we can become more God-like in our actions, in recognizing generosity and in dispensing mercy to others. While we can never equal God's ways, we can try to imitate the divine patterns of seeking and finding those who desire to work during the day but cannot. We need to be sensitive to the good-hearted who want salvation but do not know in what direction to run. But what is more also in our task is to open our hearts, be diligent with our own hands, and turn our thoughts to doing good for others. This parable also tells us of God's patience and justice. Not once, but many times, he forgives the tenants these debts. Let us now look at Psalm 103, verses 10 and 11. We are given a glimpse, as in many other places in the scriptures. We are told that the Lord has not dealt with us after our sins. He has not rewarded us according to our iniquities, for as the heaven is high above the earth, so great is his mercy toward those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far as he removed our transgressions from us. So, how God forgives us Well, we see that his forgiveness is complete. It is permanent. It is unconditional. And that is what I love about it. It's underserved. It is absolutely undeserved. We people cannot earn it. We cannot work for it. We cannot perform harder to get it. His forgiveness is all of grace. But let us also remember that while the tenants take advantage of the owner's patience and forgiveness, his judgment and justice prevail in the end. Amen. May God bless.